The following is a...
With just over 24 hours until the initial BCS standings are released, the Boise State Broncos have one more shot to stake their claim as the best in college football. For the fifth time already this season, San Jose State squares off against a top 25 opponent. Tonight, welcoming in third-ranked and unbeaten Boise State, the Broncos now have the nation's longest winning streak at 19 in a row. Hi again, everyone. Welcome to tonight's broadcast here on the WAC Sports Network. We are live at Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. I'm Dave Harbison, alongside the former head coach at Wyoming and Montana, Joe Glenn. And Joe, San Jose State has certainly played what you could call an ambitious schedule. You might even call it a bit masochistic. They've already gone 0-4 with matchups against ranked teams Alabama, Wisconsin, Utah, and Nevada.
They have faced the number 1, the number 11, number 13, and number 21 ranked teams in the United States. And they've made the athletic department a lot of money, but they paid a heavy price. They're currently down 10 starters on the season, and they are starting 7 freshmen tonight against the third best team in the United States.
So the Spartans are a bit battered and bruised as a result of that schedule, but signs of life, especially offensively lately, as in each of the last 2 games, they've posted season highs in rushing yards and total yards.
Well, tonight they got to count on number 22, the Mojo, Lamon Muldrow, a 5'9", 210-pound power horse, running back out of Pittsburgh, California. Mojo's averaging 4.7 a carry. He's got to come on tonight.
And they'll need all the offensive mojo they can muster tonight because Boise State has a take-no-prisoners attitude, especially early in the game. Last week against Toledo, they hit him with gadget plays early and often.
Well, ever since Boise State beat Oklahoma in one of the greatest finishes in college football history, they've become known for their gadget plays. Some people call them trick plays, but you can count on Chris Peterson trying to pull a few rabbits out of the hat tonight. Here you see a few plays from last week's game against Toledo, and they can run some trick plays now.
Yeah, they sure can. They'll run a lot of Wildcat. Jeremy Avery, number 27, there had 3 touchdowns in the victory over Toledo last week. And Chris Peterson, the head coach of the Broncos, unapologetic about it. This is what he had to say after the game last week. We want to show new stuff. We want the next team to put on the film and go, they've got all this stuff. How do we practice against all this stuff? Next game, we'll have some new stuff too. And style points start to count even more this week as the first BCS standings will be released tomorrow. More on that in a moment as we get you ready for Boise State at San Jose State. WAC Sports Network College Football is brought to you by Bronco Motors, Idaho's finest since 1971. Les Schwab Tire Centers, doing the right thing since 1952. R.C. Willey, your home, your way. Washington Federal, invested here. Peterson Toyota in Boise, will do almost anything. And by Papa Murphy's, get a big pep for just $7. Now that's a pizza. WAC Sports Network College Football is brought to you by Hollingshead Eye Center. Visit hollingsheadeyecenter.com and take the LASIK quiz to see if you are a LASIK candidate. Nampa Floor, go to getfloor.net for Bronco Nation savings. Chicago Connection, the official pizza of the Boise State Broncos. AAA Idaho, where your membership means more. Lithia Ford, we want your trade. LithiaFordBoise.com. CapEd, where membership supports education. And Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15%. Call Geico at 1-800-947-AUTO or visit geico.com. Back with you live from Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. Dave Harbison along with Coach Joe Glenn. More turmoil in the top 25 today as Texas has knocked off number 5 Nebraska, top-ranked Ohio State, trailing Wisconsin in the early going of that game. That's all important. For more on that story and the BCS standings, let's go down to the third member of our crew, Jenny Kavanaugh.
Yeah, Dave, in just 24 hours, the first BCS rankings will be released so we can let the great debate begin. As of now, early projections have number 3 Boise State ranked number 1 in the BCS. Whenever you ask Coach Peterson this time of year about the BCS, he usually refrains from comments, but Last night he said he had to chuckle that there was an hour special dedicated to debating the rankings in just week six of the college football season. He said it won't matter till the calendar turns to December. Now, Mike McIntyre for San Jose State, he does have a vote in the coaches poll. He said Boise deserves to be up there. He'll know more after he sees them play today. He also said you can't beat anyone that's not on your schedule, and it's just not fair to penalize you for that. Guys, let the debating begin.
The debate has already begun for weeks and weeks, but it will certainly ratchet up now with the official BCS standings to be released tomorrow night. Boise State will kick off to start the game. Today's kickoff presented by Texaco. People who know cars trust the unbeatable cleaning power of Texaco with Tecron. Chris Peterson, head coach of Boise State, fifth season, 54-4, his record. Trevor Harmon kicks it off for Boise State. San Jose State on the return out to the 12-yard line, and a rude greeting there for David Freeman. He's belted down by a couple of Boise State Broncos, and a flag on the return.
Not a good start. They got an illegal block in the back, half the distance from the 12-yard line. Start on the own six. Tough way to start against the number three team in the United States.
No kidding, and they've been offensively challenged without question. Number 116 in the country in total offense. They're led by quarterback Jordan Lasekla. He had a touchdown pass against the Broncos head-to-head last season. 61% of his passes, two touchdowns only, and five interceptions on the season. They run the pistol.
Well, that's a vast improvement for Boise on kickoff cover over what it's been for the last couple games. And that's an area where Coach Peterson wanted to improve.
And there's your guy, Lamon Muldrow. And take a look at the San Jose State offense. Big guys up front. And then the backs and receivers. Key guys here are Muldrow, we talked about, and then Jalal Beachman has caught passes in 28 consecutive games. Muldrow behind Lasekla in the pistol. A little bit of motion from San Jose State here on second and eight.
Heavy formation. That's a heavy run formation right there with a fullback and a tight end. And again,
Boise State's defense certainly among the best in the land, and the guys up front really get it going. Ryan Winterswijk and Shea McClellan on the ends. They're the linebackers. And then the secondary is very, very good and very experienced, led by Jerron Johnson, George Iloka, those couple of safeties. Third and four now for San Jose State on their opening possession.
Coming up with an unbalanced set to the wide side of the field.
And Lasekla to throw, has time, batted down by Ryan Winterswijk. Well, those two ends, Coach, really get after it. Shea McClellan had that knockdown interception return last week. Ryan Winterswijk's had a big career as a walk-on here at Boise State, and he has become an All-American candidate.
Well, you got to get Winterswijk's hands down. It's a three-step drop. You can't set up for pass. You got to cut him and get his hands down. And consequently, he jumped up. Got to cut them down low and get their hands down for a three-step drop.
Harrison Wade will punt for San Jose State. It's Chris Potter back to receive for Boise State. He's standing right about the 50-yard line, so the Broncos will get great field position to start this game. Wade's kick is a good one. Potter hit as he tried to make the catch, and flags all over the place. You have to give the receiver, obviously, room to catch the football.
It's raining flags. He was interfered with, didn't get a fair chance to catch the football.
So they'll tack on some additional yardage, and Boise State will start with their first possession on the San Jose State side of the field. And the Broncos, just amazing how quick they are getting out of the gate. They've outscored their opponents 80-14 in the opening quarter this season.
Yeah, they start about, they talk about starting fast with high energy. You watch on your screen here. Tui Padaloto interfered with the catch. So Boise starts with the ball on the 36-yard line.
36-yard line, and that bodes well for this trend. Boise State scored on their opening drive in all five games this season. Three touchdowns, two field goals. They jump on you early.
Spread set.
Kellen Moore at the controls, throwing on first down, has a man over the middle. It's Kyle Ifo down to the 17-yard line before he's gently, not so gently, roughed up, I guess, by San Jose State. Here's Kellen Moore closing in on becoming the all-time completion leader in Boise State history. In fact, he's now tied, Bart Hendricks, with that completion right there. One more, and he has first place all to himself.
Beautiful touch passer. I've said it before, he throws a receiver-friendly ball that's easy to catch.
Tight end Gallarda goes in motion and give it off to Doug Martin, who has plenty of running room inside the 10, down close to the 5-yard line for the Broncos.
Doug Martin's a lot like Mojo, another 5'9", 212-pound running back. You'll see him on a cutback play. It's zone right. He presses it, cuts it back. First down. Right into your living room here. Doug Martin, tough dude.
Nice block on the outside by the tight end Gallarda. Gave Martin additional running room, and they go first and goal now from just outside the 5. Call it the 6 officially. And Kellen Moore gives it off to Martin. Tries the left side. Spartans rallying to the football. Martin, what a great individual effort. Dives into the end zone. Touchdown, Boise State.
Same play, zone right. Martin cuts it back and then continues to bounce it all the way to the edge. 6-yard touchdown run. Here it is again.
Looked like San Jose State had it pretty well defended initially, Coach.
Well, he just out-athleted some guys here. Broken tackle. Good blocks on the perimeter, and then way to finish. Doug Martin, tough run for the 5'9", 212-pound senior.
So it's 6-for-6 on the opening drive for Boise State this season, and they jump on the San Jose State Spartans with an early scoring drive. And we'll take a break and come back and see what the Spartans can muster on drive number 2. Spartan Stadium in San Jose. Boise State with the early lead. You're watching the WAC Sports Network, a production of Learfield Sports. Back in San Jose, Boise State Broncos, number 3 in the land in most of the major polls, with an early lead over San Jose State 7-0. Time for the Bronco Motors Hyundai Keys to the Game, Idaho's finest since 1971.
Boise likes to start out with an early round knockout, and that's the way you start. 3 and out, they got a penalty, set them up, and then struck early. 2 runs and a throw, pre-play drive, and then for San Jose, they need to establish a running game. They didn't have a fair chance there, starting at the shadows of their own goalposts, but they also need to protect their quarterback if they need to throw. Toledo did not have a chance to throw last week. No, too much pass rush from Boise State.
Keys to the Game brought to you by Bronco Motors. Check us out online anytime at broncomotors.com. San Jose State coaches talked about needing to establish the running game, partly so they can maybe have a little bit of time to throw, and they're going to try and get some running game going to be able to throw play action. They've gone to the pistol offense, which generally speaking is more of a wide open offense, but they're trying to work some kind of hybrid offense here.
They are. We'll talk a little more about it a little later in the broadcast, but Harmon kicks off. They need to get better field position right here.
It's Freeman at the 3-yard line for the Spartans, 15. 20 has a little bit of running room, knocked down at the 25-yard line.
Little breathing room here. Take over first and 10 at their own 24, if you will, 25-yard line.
22 yards on the return for Freeman. There's your scoring drive. Quick and easy as far as the Boise State Broncos were concerned. One pass play from Kellen Moore to Kyle Ifo, and then a couple of nice runs by Doug Martin.
The Spartans need to keep Boise's offense off the field. They need to use the clock a little bit, do some running.
Sekla going long on first down, has a man down there, and a flag goes down as there's contact. Pass intended for Josh Harrison. Brandon Thompson on the coverage for Boise State.
I'd like to see it again. Like they were both feeling each other out there a little bit. Ball was on the money. Interesting to see what they call him.
Defense, number 13. 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
Harrison's one of their speed receivers. Lasekla throws a About a 50-yard pass. They put a feeler on him, leaned into him. Pass interference.
Harrison has missed some games and parts of other games because of injury this season. When he's in there, he's very effective. He's a good weapon for them. 10 catches on the year for 162 yards. He's a junior out of Oxnard, California.
Got some wheels.
The real speed guy is 89, Chandler Jones, high school track star from the Los Angeles area. First and 10 now for San Jose State, and they run the football straight up the middle. That's Brandon Rutley into the game now as the running back. And coach, the Spartans have a kind of a nice 1-2 punch at running back. They have a power guy and a speed guy.
Right, Brandon Rutley being the speed guy. Just hit a straight dive again there for 4 yards, and they need a lot of that tonight. But Rutley had, as a sophomore, or 2 years ago, I should say, Rutley had a big touchdown against Boise State, and so he feels confident that he can break one. He's done it before.
Three wide receivers right for Lasekla and the Spartans.
Bootleg.
Play action to Rutley, and then Lasekla on the roll.
Look out.
And that's Winston Venable coming up out of the secondary, making the very sure tackle.
Jordan's got to get rid of the ball there. If there's nothing there, throw it out of bounds. Don't take the sack. Now you're second and 11.
And it looks like he has a little pass run option. No receivers in the area, at least none open. And Winston Venable closes in a hurry. You know, the way they run the pistol, they've thrown a lot more, unlike Nevada, which with Kaepernick, who runs so much. Part of that's been because Lasekla hasn't been healthy, though.
Well, he won't stay healthy if he don't figure that one out. He's got to learn to throw the ball away. Now they're second or third and long. Right? Didn't want to be in this again.
Winston Venable, second team All-WAC last year. Third and 11 for San Jose State. Lasekla back to throw, runs away from the pressure, has a man. It's complete along the sidelines. It'll be short of the first down, but he finds Chandler Jones, the speedster we were talking about a minute ago, freshman out of Los Angeles.
Not enough.
But at least you shift field position,
right,
a little bit.
Right, you do. Yeah, but the sack, hate to beat a dead horse, but the sack there really cost them. They would have been first down inside the 50. Now they've got to give the ball back to Boise State. One of the top scoring teams in the United States. I think they're currently fifth in the nation in scoring offense.
Harrison Wade to boot it away again. And it's Potter back to receive for Boise State. This is a short kick. He'll just wave everybody away from that one and let it roll dead at the 15-yard line. So a little more challenging for Boise State this time around, as they'll have to drive it most of the length of the field. Short scoring drive on the opening possession. Boise State up on the Spartans, 7-0. College football on a Saturday evening in San Jose, California. Boise State out in front of San Jose State, 7-0. Bronco basketball just around the corner with the opening exhibition game under new head coach Leon Rice just 2 weeks away. Doug Martin on the carry for the Broncos, has good running room and good yardage. This Thursday night from 5:30 to 7 is a chance to meet the coaches and players, and also check out great seats that are still available at a free of charge basketball open house at Taco Bell Arena. That's this coming Thursday, 5:30 to 7 at Taco Bell Arena.
Peyton Thompson has taken a 15-yard personal foul. See how they mark it. It was a little jawn after the play. And they called it on. Titus Young. I just saw the end of it.
Well, that'll back him all the way up to the 15-yard line. You know, this San Jose State defense coach, we talked about the injuries and how young they are. They only had 78 scholarship guys to begin with because of some APR issues. And then all those injuries. There are times they're playing with seven freshmen in the defensive 11.
And a couple guys are going to play both ways.
Yeah.
Incredible.
The linebackers are a strong unit. That may be the strength of this defense. Here's a pitch to Doug Martin. Has a hole on the right side across the 25, maybe the 27-yard line.
Doug Martin getting some work in. He didn't get much work in last week.
Yep, we talked with Chris Peterson about that a little bit, too, as a matter of fact. The fact that Doug Martin had a fairly light week and Jeremy Avery had the big game, and Yeah, Doug, I think, was somewhat appreciative of the little extra rest. Nice burst there. He looks very fresh. But he's also one of those guys that if you get him 20 carries, 25 carries, he'll start pounding on you in the fourth quarter and just get better and better.
He's tough. And he, at one time, he moved him over to defense and then back to offense with some injuries. And tough kid.
First and 10 for Kellen Moore and the Boise State Broncos. Moore back to throw. Has Titus Young. That pass is complete along the sidelines, and that one puts Kellen Moore into the record books. He is now the all-time leader in Boise State history in pass completions.
It's a thing of beauty. That was a sideline route. He set up and threw the ball before they even came out of the cut. Ball feathered in.
And here's your reward, kid. Have a seat on the bench now that you're a record holder. We're going to run a little Wildcat here. Coughlin. No, rather Southwick. Joe Southwick is from the Bay Area, the sophomore quarterback. Throws it out here, complete.
Bubble screen, he's got some room.
He does have some room, pushed out of bounds.
He had unbalanced trips to the field. We need an adjustment. Get over there and cover it. We were outflanked. San Jose was, and they threw the bubble screen, and play went for about 15 yards.
Tyler Shoemaker on the receiving end. This is Joe Southwick, 15. Looks to be the heir apparent at quarterback. Nice completion to Shoemaker. Southwick's from Danville, California, San Ramon Valley High School, redshirt freshman technically.
Corner has to turn that back into pursuit. He cannot let that bubble screen get outside.
And Kellen Moore back in there.
Uh-oh.
And there goes Kellen on a gallop across the 45.
He's safe.
He goes down again. He had about a 6-yard run last week.
He really broke
loose. And we talked with the Boise State coaches. They said Kellen took off in practice on a run the other day, and all of his teammates were flabbergasted and ended up clapping for him.
Well, he's got to do that once in a while.
He does.
They're going to drop eight into coverage. He's got to pull it down and scramble a little bit. Second and 6, not a bad call.
Doug Martin in the setback spot behind Kellen Moore, deep setback, and Martin has the ball and ahead of steam and room to run across the 25, well, across the 35 rather, down to about the 30-yard line.
San Jose's a little out man. They had 8 guys in the box and still couldn't stop it for less than 10-yard gain. Here it is. Good push up front, little wraparound power play.
Will Lawrence with a big block there, 59. Sets up a new set of downs for Boise State, first and 10. Kellen Moore to throw, a little bit of pressure, gets it away to Titus Young. Titus dodges a tackle, 20, and out of bounds at about the 17-yard line.
Good check down by Kellen Moore, nothing open deep. Checked it down to the crosser. Titus, nice move here, you'll see it. Crossing from your right to left on your TV screen. Little move to the outside, got a few more yards and out of bounds. He don't want to take a hit.
All right, coming up the 8th play of this drive for Boise State. 3 plays, 36 yards for the score in the opening drive. Moore over the middle, wide open. Touchdown, Tommy Gallardo.
Touchdown, Tommy. Empty backfield, they spread it out, ran verticals with everybody going vertical down the field, and nobody had over the top on the tight end. He was flexed out, and cha-ching. Easy throw from Kellen Moore to touchdown Tommy Gallardo.
Well, they just throw so many different formations and looks at you that for a young defense, just too much to handle. That was Keith Smith, the linebacker, trying to stay with Gallardo, the Boise State tight end.
That's his 3rd touchdown of the season. Efa's got, I think, 3 as well. Loading up on the tight ends.
Kyle Brotzman adds the extra point. And Boise State out in front of the San Jose State Spartans. A quick start on the road. Broncos up 14-0. Fifteenth touchdown pass of the season for Kellen Moore has put Boise State up 14-0 here in the first quarter. 2010 WAC soccer tournament heading to Ruston, Louisiana, November 4th, 5th, and 7th. The top 6 teams in the conference will compete for the tournament title, an automatic berth to the NCAA tournament. All session tournament tickets are on sale now and can be purchased through WACSports.com. Freeman and Yell deep to receive for San Jose State. Once again, it's Trevor Harmon doing the kicking off chores for Boise State.
Short kick.
Freeman again, this time from the other side of the field, from the left side. Has a little bit of success there, up to about the 28-yard line. Let's head down to the field and check in with Jenny Kavnar and a special guest.
Yeah, guys, Will Venable, he plays for the San Diego Padres. You might recognize the last name, the brother of Winston Venable, who plays for Boise State. Now, Will, I know you'd rather be in the playoffs this time of year with baseball, but how much fun is it for you to be able to come out and watch your brother play?
Well, the only thing I would give up the playoffs for is to be able to come out here and watch my brother play. It means a lot to me, means a lot to the family, so we're happy to be out here.
Yeah, you guys have a very athletic family. Your dad, Max, had a Major League Baseball career, coaches within the Padres organization. You were a two-sport athlete at Princeton, also playing basketball. Heard your mom even played some college basketball. So out of all you guys, who's the most athletic in the family?
Got to give it up to Winston. You know, he does a great job going out there and doing his thing and can do a little bit of everything. And football is the sport he plays, but he could probably be doing any sport he wanted to right now.
Now, we know you're having fun rooting around, but I have to ask you, put you on the spot a little bit. Giants, Phillies playing right now. Who do you got in that game?
I think it's going to be a great game. You know, not too happy that the Giants beat us, but, you know, they did beat us, and wish them the best, and I think it's going to be a great series.
All right, Will, thanks so much for joining us. Guys, we'll send it back to you.
All right, Matt Faulkner in, a quarterback for San Jose State. He generally will play the third series. His first play in this game was not one to remember. Center snapped it over his head out of that shotgun formation, set up second and long, and now third and long for San Jose State.
Lamont Muldrow's down.
Of course, Winston Venable's not the only one with a family connection to baseball. Austin Pettis of Boise State, his uncle Gary, was a major league player and a pretty good one for a long time.
Some athleticism in that family. Austin, they think, is a guy that will play in the National Football League.
San Jose State just riddled with injuries all season long, as we've talked about, and this is a guy that they can ill afford to lose. Muldrow, their starting running back. Again, 10 starters out for the season, seven of them, I believe, coach seniors. And Mike McIntyre really talked about that aspect of it, that he's first-year head coach, wants to come in and make that senior season a memorable one for these guys, and so many of them are out with injuries.
It's just heartbreaking, and not much you can say about it. The fact that the guy's in his senior season and to have it taken away is just tragic. But they're fighting through it. Stand positive. Know that the future looks bright. Going to get out and recruit. Take the high road. Coach McIntyre's got it.
Yeah, you'd spend a
fall of enthusiasm.
Spend a few minutes with him, and it's his first head coaching job, but he certainly has the pedigree. His father was the head coach at Vanderbilt, George McIntyre. Muldrow getting off with a little bit of help. We'll get you an update on him as soon as we can. But Mike McIntyre also, in terms of his mentors, David Cutcliffe, he coached under him at Mississippi and most recently defensive coordinator at Duke, and Bill Parcells. Mike McIntyre spent some time with Parcells on the staff of the Dallas Cowboys. A pretty good story about that that we'll tell a bit later on.
Good pedigree, 20 years in coaching.
Intense guy, certainly talking about Mike McIntyre. Get the sense that he will do a very nice job here. Faulkner in, a quarterback on third and 18, handed off to the backup running back, Brandon Rutley. He spins his way out across the 25-yard line. Nice little run. It'll be well short of the first down, but gains a little bit in terms of field position.
It's a real good run for 5 yards. Spun off a couple tackles and made positive yardage. It gave punt team a little room. They need to get field position and hold Boise State. That's easy for me to say, but got to get a stop on defense.
Harrison Wade in to punt it away for San Jose State. Had a terrific week. He's both the punter and kicker. Had a great week last week for them against Nevada. Potter, the deep man on the return for
Much
Boise State.
Punt.
Very good punt. Potter fields it at the 28. Across the 40. A little bit of a seam. And big hit. Big hit right at the 43-yard line.
Travis Johnson. He had him dialed in. Watch number 43. Left of your screen. Watch this hit.
Oh,
that is picture perfect.
That'll shake your teeth loose, won't it?
Any of you young guys watching, head across the bow, arms wrapped up. That is a form tackle, just like nice tackle, Travis.
So you want to be a punt returner, kid. Potter is a tough customer, though, and getting more and more involved with this Boise State team all the time within the offense and in the return game. And don't look now, Boise State is about to get even more weapons. Mitch Burrows, they hope will be back for the Louisiana Tech game coming up next Tuesday. First and 10, Boise State, and give it off to Avery on a little sweep left. Plenty of running room for Avery. Finally tripped up at about the 48-yard line of San Jose State.
Their coaching staff talks about starting fast and playing fast and coming out with the eye of the tiger. And they've certainly done it again, just like they did a week ago and the week before that. But that's a challenge when you come up against a team like San Jose State that's struggling.
Mike McIntyre, the other thing he said, and probably won't happen based on the start here, but he said he was on the staff at Temple when they beat Virginia Tech as a 37.5-point underdog. Boise State clearly a prohibitive favorite in this game and out to the 14-0 lead. Kellen Moore on the handoff, on the give. It's Avery again. Jukes his way forward. Finally pushed back, but not until he gets first down yardage. Vince Buhajer, the freshman linebacker for San Jose State, he's a really good player in on the tackle there.
Coaching staff has had a lot of great things to say about Vince. I think he's been the leading tackler in three of their games as a true freshman. Came here to play offense, moved over to defense because of injuries, and defensive leader, Vince Buhajer.
Buhajer and Smith and Tui Peloto, the linebackers, that crew is pretty good. They can keep everybody healthy. That unit may have a bright future. Kellen Moore to throw, checks it down underneath to Jeremy Avery, gets involved in the passing game, and that's good for a gain of about 7 yards.
Doing a nice job of dropping, taking the deep pass and the intermediate pass away. So Kellen checks down to his underneath crosser again. Second time they've thrown that play. It's a good play, 7 yards, second and three. I don't mind calling play at second and three. I think we'll give it to the tailback.
Jake Hess lined up as the fullback in this I formation set. And it's Jeremy Avery hitting the backfield and pushed back.
There you go.
That's 92, Pablo Garcia.
Backside, get the backside sealed off.
Bring up third and five, fifth play of the drive now for Boise State. Broncos up a couple of touchdowns here in the early going.
Big tackle by Pablo. Came off the backside, closed it down, made a sure tackle.
He's a hometown kid out of San Jose. Third and five for Boise State. And Moore to throw, a little bit of rush, but he gets it out to Doug Martin, complete first down yardage. Martin still on his feet, puts his head down and dives forward to about the 22. Martin is also a California kid. He's from Stockton, St. Mary's High School.
Right.
And you know, there's a pretty heavy California flavor on this Boise State team, and as a result, Bronco Nation has traveled quite well here to San Jose. They've got a bunch of orange and blue in attendance here to cheer on not only their team, but in a lot of cases, family members and friends.
Well, they've always traveled well in the beautiful city of Boise, Idaho.
Coughlin in a quarterback on a roll now. It's trying to get away from the pressure and finally does. Diving forward, pushed out of bounds at the 17, 18-yard line. Coach, that one should have been about a 5-yard loss.
Pretty nifty. Made a couple quick moves and evaded the tackle and made 5 yards. Fans weren't too happy with it, but I gotta give Coughlin a little props there. He made a nice little cut. Made a 5-yard run out of nothing.
Coughlin is the senior out of San Diego, California, Mira Mesa High School. Get all three of those quarterbacks in the mix, and then they'll run Avery and Potter and out of the Wildcat formation. Here's a little trickery. It's Titus Young on the end around, and he will take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Boise State.
They make it look so darn easy, Dave. We had three defenders out there. They got one blocked, and the other two just made a inside. Watch the movie makes inside, then bounces out. Watch number one on the left of your screen. He'll take it on the reverse. He'll set it inside. Now watch the bounce outside. There's a great block.
Kyle Efaw really sprung him for that last 5 yards or so and the touchdown. Brotsman on to add the extra point now for Boise State.
Great athletes make it look so easy.
And the Broncos up 21-0, a minute 19 to play here in the first quarter in San Jose. You know, the Boise State coaches, when we talk to them about the gadget plays or trick plays or whatever you want to call them. They say they have a lot in the playbook, so to speak, but it's kind of a week-to-week basis, isn't it, as to what specifically they want to run.
They don't want to show you the same play two weeks in a row. So they trade film with you. You're going to see something they did last week, and then you may not see that again for a month or so. They're very good at a lot of different gadgets, but they're also good at running up from different sets.
Yep, and they a lot of the trick plays or the gadget plays come out of film study of that opponent. They're specifically geared toward that opponent. Now, they may put it in the playbook and run it or not run it, but they'll recycle it at some point down the road. It might be a few weeks. It might even be next year, but they'll come back to it.
The aha factor. They'll be looking at film on Sunday night and go, aha. They'll pull the old gadget out from the Oklahoma days.
Well, and as we mentioned in the pregame show, Chris Peterson says we want the next opponent to be having to look at film and try and figure it out. So Louisiana Tech coaches are going to have their hands full getting ready for that Tuesday night game.
Travis Harmon getting tired.
Well, that's one of the reasons they don't want Brotsman to kick off anymore. Keep his legs somewhat fresh for the field goal opportunities. Flag on this return. On the return, it's Ronnie Yell for San Jose State. 17-yard return, but some of it may come back.
Ronnie Yell had 4 pass breakups in an earlier game this year, tying a school record single game. Good cornerback, Ronnie Yell.
All right, so no penalty on the plate. Give credit for the 17-yard return. Let's go down to the sidelines and bring in Jenny Kavnar.
On Muldrill's face says it all. Very disappointed right now. Uncertain of his return in this game and possibly his return in the next couple of games. I overheard him telling a fan in the crowd that it could be an ACL injury. Trainers were even consoling him at one point. You can tell he has ice wrapped around his right knee. Many teammates have come up and also consoled him again. This team has lost 7 seniors this year. This would be one senior you don't want to lose.
Yeah, he's been the focal point of the offense of late as they've gotten it going a little bit in the past 2 weeks. Even in a losing effort, they've had some positives, and he was the biggest one. And that's just a heartbreaking deal. And he's a great human interest story, too, Coach. One of 14 kids, 13 brothers and sisters. I believe he's the first one from that group to go to college and on track to graduate. So very, very disappointed, obviously, by the injury.
Mojo, good luck, Mojo.
Sekla back to throw now on 3rd and 8. Here comes the rush. Ball is loose. And a scramble for it at the 22-yard line.
Like sharks.
That was Jarrell Root on the pressure, knocking the ball loose. Boy, he and Tyrone Crawford really come off the bench and played well out of that second defensive line unit for Boise State.
Top of your screen, you're going to see blitz coming hard. You can't hold the ball against this defense. A lot of people think that
one more look at it here, and San Jose State does come up with the loose football in this pile here.
Hey, this is a defense, Dave, that held Oregon last year to 1 touchdown, and they didn't have a first down till 7 minutes left in the third quarter.
First quarter is in the books here in San Jose, California. Boise State up on the San Jose State Spartans 21-0. First quarter, all Boise State. Broncos lead it 21-0 over the Spartans of San Jose State. The Marriott Courtyard in Meridian is located off Interstate 84 and Eagle Road. The hotel's Central Valley location is perfect for your next corporate event, party, or travel needs throughout the year. 3rd and 13 coming up for San Jose State as we start quarter number 2. Sekla fires it out here complete. Be well short of the first down. That's Kyle Nunn on the receiving end. And short of the first down, but a completion. First quarter numbers coming at you, as we said, pretty much all Boise State.
95 yards rushing to 0. 95 yards passing to 8. That's dominance, what you'd figure from the number 3 ranked team in the nation against a team that's starting 7 freshmen.
Our look at the stats brought to you by AAA Idaho. Boise State likes to be balanced offensively. They usually are. Here's the punt. Broncos going to get their hands on the football again. Potter backtracking all the way to the 18-yard line. Clip dodges a man. No flag. Sure looked like it as we saw it live. But nice tackle anyway. And Boise State will start from their own 18-yard line. Harrison Wade has done a nice job punting and kicking for San Jose State.
His first shot was 33 yards, and since then he's hit a couple of beauties. Turned the nose over. Once that ball goes over at the top, it's going to carry another 15 to 20 yards, and great coverage by Spartans that time. They got down, and I thought he got nudged in the back there a little bit. But
Wade's averaging 42 and a half yards a kick. Last week he had 260 yards.
Good job, Harrison.
All right, that injury-riddled San Jose State defense trying to dig in and get something accomplished now against the powerful and prolific Boise State offense. Pass complete to Titus Young. A little bubble screen. Picks up 3, maybe 4 yards.
I don't think Killen got as much on that as he likes. Ball's got to be frozen rope. But longer it carries it, hangs in the air, the more time the defense has to rally on that bubble screen.
Kellen has already become Boise State's all-time leader in pass completions. He has a touchdown pass here, so he's trying to close in on that record as well. Needs 3 more to tie Ryan Dinwiddie for number one in touchdown passes. He will have, in all likelihood, rewritten the Boise State record book by the time he's done.
It's incredible, the records that he has within his grasp. Not only at Boise State, but in the conference and nationally.
Yeah, he leads the nation in passing efficiency.
Right.
183.28 passing efficiency number, completion percentage for the season at 67.4%. It's 100% here this evening. 7 for 7 so far for Kellen Moore. Back to Broncos up 5 yards though. 2nd and 10. Efaw in motion and Moore to throw. Titus Young.
Jailbreak.
Blockers in front of him. It was a nice tackle. That's Ronnie Yell.
What they're trying to do is kick the corner and perimeter people out and then run back underneath it behind the lineman. And Ronnie Yell came in off the perimeter block and made a great tackle.
Ronnie Yell, sophomore out of Lincoln High School in San Diego. 3rd and 4 for Boise State.
Big stop here for the Spartans.
Doug Martin is your running back. And Kellen Moore to throw. Has Austin Pettis. That's complete to the 35 and across the 40 and out of bounds.
Again, the timing of the route, timing of the throw, impeccable.
First catch of the night. 23rd on the year for Austin Pettis. He's averaging over 15 yards a catch and has 4 touchdowns.
He's going to throw an out route to his stop route, actually, to his left, but he no sooner stops, turns around, and the ball is presented to him on the numbers.
Austin Pettis also climbing the record books for Boise State, climbing those charts. Here's Titus Young in motion, and Southwick in at quarterback throwing it. Has a man wide open. That is complete to Tyler Shoemaker. Nope, incomplete.
It was a catchable ball, but it was a little bit behind him. I think he'd like to have
to take a look here.
Yep. He's throwing a corner route at the top of your screen on the right.
Yep. Should have been caught, but you're right. It wasn't the right. Greatest throw in the world either.
They put Kellen back in now.
Austin Pettis already Broncos all-time leader in touchdown receptions.
2nd and 10.
And Kellen Moore gives it off to Jeremy Avery. Hit in the backfield, but shakes loose and gets positive yardage after the initial contact was about 3 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Cedric Losey in the backfield. Slowed him down. Great second effort here by the running back. Looks to me like San Jose's picking up the speed of the game a little bit as we move forward here.
The Spartan crowd, despite being down 21-0, trying to get in it and support their team on a key 3rd and 8.
Need a punt. They need to get him off the field.
Yeah, they do. Here comes the pass rush. Moore hit as he throws, and mission accomplished from the San Jose State standpoint. Great pass rush and Boise State will now be forced to punt.
That's Travis Johnson again, the fellow that made a great tackle on special teams. Watch.
Coming
that doesn't
the
happen
edge.
Very often. He's been sacked once this year. And I guess this is not qualified as a sack, but it's a hurry if there ever was one.
Yeah, I mean, Kellen Moore doesn't get his uniform dirty very often.
No grass stains at all. Great job, Travis Johnson. That's a great rush. Beat the right tackle.
Heads up here as Boise State is in punt formation.
Rugby punt.
It is a rugby punt. Fielded by the Spartans. And that's
Brandon Rutley.
Yep, Rutley has some room to work.
Not afraid. Give me that ball.
It was Trevor Harmon doing the punting that time for Boise State. So the Spartans will get the football back as we come back from break, following a defensive stand and a big hit. Kellen Moore and the Boise State Broncos having a big night so far. For more on that, let's go down to the sidelines and Jenny Kavnar.
Guys, when we caught up with offensive coordinator Brian Harsin yesterday, he said he really looks at two categories to grade his quarterbacks on week in and week out. It's pass efficiency. They want it to be above 160. That's a good thing because this team's leading the nation with a pass efficiency around 190. They also want the completion percentage to be about 60% weekly. Last week, Kellen 72%. Today, 9 for 10 with 110 yards. I'd say he's grading out pretty well right now.
Are so good from the Boise State perspective, certainly. And here's Freeman in the backfield and hit in the backfield by the Boise State Broncos. Freeman, essentially the third team tailback in there because of the injury to Muldrow. Rutley and now David Freeman, the sophomore out of Inglewood, California, getting some carries. And he gets roughed up a bit by
J.C. Percy and friends.
Boise State number two in the nation in total defense. 236 yards game is all they're allowing.
This defense is for real. They shut down TCU last year in the bowl game. I don't think Boise gets enough credit for how good their defense is.
And there's LaSecla with a completion to Jalal Beachman, and that keeps his streak alive. 29 consecutive games with a pass reception for Beachman.
We saw it a week ago, Dave. They didn't have time to throw against Toledo, and LaSecla's just got to get back and get rid of the ball on rhythm. He cannot hold the ball. Nice delivery there, got the ball out, but they were breathing down his neck.
Beachman is 13th on the all-time San Jose State list, and they've had some pretty darn good football players come through this university. The recent pass has been a little shaky in some respects, but there have been some really good football players and athletes in general that have come through this campus.
They've got 10 guys playing in the NFL as we speak.
LaSecla hit as he throws,
nice,
but it's still complete. And that'll be good for a San Jose State first down.
That's a timing throw right there. Crowd wants a shot, wants a flag on LaSecla on his follow through. They think he took a late hit, but I don't think so. That's fair. Tough kid.
Chase Baker that bumped into him just a bit.
Calling card, call that. Nice throw for LaSecla. That's, again, a timing route. And two guys all over the receiver, but.
Well, the theory was that you were going to try and run, from San Jose State's perspective, you're going to try and run the football a little bit, set up play action, but you've lost your best running threat in Muldrow. This is Rutley. He's not nearly as big and physical a back as Muldrow. Rutley goes 5'10", 190 out of Alhambra High School in Martinez, California.
Shane McClellan loose, so he hits him 2 yards deep in the backfield. That can't happen. But again, you're playing some freshmen, some younger players that aren't as experienced as the Boise team. Rutley's got to have a little more room to run than 2 yards deep.
It really is an amazing divergence, if you want to call it that, for these two teams, how young and inexperienced San Jose State is and how veteran and savvy and experienced Boise State is. LaSecla on the completion. Once again, it's Beachman, and that's down to about the 21-yard line. Nice job.
Great job of Jordan buying some time with that heavy pass rush. He scrambled out, made a little room for himself, and threw the out route about 20 yards downfield, and they are knocking the touchdown door at the plus 21-yard line.
Well, they are only at 36% touchdown percentage once they get into the red zone. They've only scored six touchdowns in six games. So it's been a tough go offensively. They're 116th in the nation. Total offense.
Spin move. Oh!
Ball is loose. Picked up by Jerron Johnson. Looks like they're going to call
him
down.
He is down. He better hang on the ball because boy, she smells blood, though. Tear that ball out.
Broncos very opportunistic last week. 5-0 winning the turnover battle against Toledo. Here's another look at it. Ripped out of there. He was down, but Darrell Acree just ripped it out of there.
Empty set. Doubles left, trips right.
Seclon, 2nd-and-8 for the Spartans. Pass time. Quick gets it out of there quickly. Incomplete.
Hit the play they wanted.
Bruntley out of the backfield, the intended receiver, actually flanked out to start the play out of the empty set. Brings up 3rd-and-8.
Actually, got Venable hooked up with a wideout one-on-one, and we'll talk about Venable a little bit more covering. They don't really want him to get man-to-man very often, but he is an incredible athlete. Plays as a hybrid safety outside linebacker.
Mike McIntyre, the head coach, and the offensive coordinator, Tim Landis, both telling us yesterday, we've been able to move the ball fairly well between the 20s. Once we get into that red zone, we have not really been able to finish it. And here's a little end around for San Jose State. Doesn't work all that well. It's Josh Harrison. And once again, they will have to settle for the field goal try.
Jarrell Gavins, tackle up.
Iloka staying home. Jarrell Gibbons on the hit as well. Harrison Wade will try the field goal from 36 yards. It is looked like somebody got a hand on that. It is no good and I believe was partially blocked. Coming right back in a moment to Spartan Stadium in San Jose, California. The scoring opportunity fizzles out for San Jose State. Boise State on the attack when we come back. Number 3 in the nation, Boise State, trying to put on a show tonight, and so far so good in terms of that. They lead it 21-0. The next home football game for the Broncos against Louisiana Tech Tuesday, October 26th at 6 o'clock. Tickets still remain, so visit the athletic ticket office or go to idahotickets.com. As part of the community outreach plan, fans are encouraged to bring any household items or gently used clothing that could be donated to the Easter Seals Goodwill Collection bins at the stadium gates. And there's another big play offensively for the Broncos. Titus Young this time around.
It's a fade route. He's got outside corner. Settled along the far sideline, and again the safety couldn't get over there to make the play. He had to come all the way off the hash, and Kellen Moore feathered it in there. It's a great throw.
First and 10 from the 43. Quick out of the huddle this time for Boise State.
It's like a run set with a fullback tight end. Play action pass.
Play action for Kellen Moore.
Oh, yeah.
Has a man open, and it's complete to Aaron Burks.
New number for us here the last couple weeks.
We were talking with Brian Harsin a little bit about the next wave of receivers, if you will, for Boise State. The two outstanding seniors, Titus Young and Austin Pettis, will be moving on. But you've got Tyler Shoemaker, and you've got Hewat and Aaron Burks here on this catch. And then Kellen Moore's younger brother, Kirby Moore, played last year, is being redshirted this year. But he'll be back next year, too. So they feel pretty comfortable about the group that's behind Young and Pettis.
6'2", 290-pound freshman from Grand Prairie, Texas. Good looking.
And here is Titus Young on the run for Boise State. Minimal gain.
Nothing doing. It's number James Orth. I've got the right guy. He's playing both ways.
81. Don't see many DBs wearing 81.
He's been a wide receiver playing defense. That's what it's all about here for San Jose State Spartans. Having to play guys both ways and teach them double, that's don't have to do that in high school very often.
2nd-and-8 for Kellen Moore and the Broncos. He's going downtown for Titus Young.
What a
Has
throw.
Him. Touchdown, Broncos.
What a throw. beat Peyton Thompson in the corner one-on-one. Thompson had no help. Killen threw a strike.
The initial coverage is pretty good, and then Titus Young just runs past the defender, and like you said, Kellen Moore puts it right there.
He knows where he's got one-on-one and pumped it the other side to freeze the safety a little bit, looked the safety off. Thompson had no help over the top, and Kellen feathers it in there.
Rotsman's extra point try is no good. Wide to the right, one of the few things that has gone wrong for Boise State. Kellen Moore to Titus Young. Touchdown for the Broncos. Boise State quarterback triumvirate. Two touchdown passes on the night for Kellen Moore. Broncos up big 27-0. A lot of sporting events going on in this area. The LPGA Tour among them, just up the road this week in the San Ramon Valley. And one familiar face to San Jose State fans is former Spartan Julie Inkster, who played here from 1979 to 82. Made the cut.
Reminds me of Marty Tarr making that putt there.
Marty, our outstanding director down in the truck.
Yes, sir. And a golfer. Scratch.
And this is Yell on the return for San Jose State. Nice return at that. Out to about the 37-yard line.
Yell's
kicker,
got some.
Harmon made the tackle.
Get up and go.
That's the second touchdown pass of the night for Kellen Moore. On the season, number 16, and for his career, number 80. Now needs just two more to tie Ryan Dinwiddie for top spot all time in Boise State history.
Mind-boggling, Dave, everything that kid's got going on. Hey, he's a junior. Don't we got to worry about it.
Well, yeah, he's also 31-1 as a starter.
That's
there's only one quarterback that has more than that among active players, Andy Dalton at TCU, and he's a senior. Here's Lasekla with time to throw, and that pass is overthrown, incomplete. George Iloco, one of the terrific Boise State safeties, on the coverage over there. And we're talking with the Boise State coaches about Iloco, Venable, and Johnson, and the roles that each of them play. From a coach's standpoint, tell us a little bit about what each of those guys brings to the table.
These guys, first off, he said they're great people. Secondly, he said, this is Pete Kwiatkowski talking, the defensive coordinator, he said they're great people. Number two, they're great students. Number three, they're great football players. And he said it just kind of all makes sense when they've got all three in one package. All three of those safeties are excellent.
Second and 10 for San Jose State. Give, running play, very little gain there. Venable of the three. Venable has the role more of the
outside linebacker.
He'll be the blitzer. He'll come on some of those situations. Iloka's the field safety and will be has to be a little better in terms of skill
space.
Coverage.
Jaron Johnson.
Yep.
Coming down. He's been the leading tackler now. He led as a sophomore, as a junior, and he's a leading tackler this year. And he hits with the eye of the tiger. He's a tough one.
All three of them will hit. I guarantee you that. They all are very physical players. Johnson will line up against the tight end. And yes, he's the leading tackler. And there is a terrific play. Interception Aaron Tevis for Boise State. He may take it all the way. 10-5, dragged down, but dives into the end zone. Touchdown.
Aaron Tevis, what a play. Jump up and catch the ball with one hand like that. I think we get another look at it. It's worth looking at again.
Well, last week it was Shea McClellan with the pick and return for the touchdown for Boise State. That is a terrific one-handed grab by Tevis. And then look at the way the guys go from defense to offense and turn into blockers.
They know what they're doing. Tucson, Arizona, 6'3", 231-pound junior linebacker Aaron Tevis. And he knows where the end zone is, I'll tell you that.
Boy, he had a convoy. Kyle Nunn dragged him down right at the end. But touchdown, Boise State. Rotsman true this time on the extra point, and the Broncos now lead it 34-0 as we take another look at this. Boise State, just as if they don't do enough damage offensively, now they're finding ways to score defensively as well.
Tevis came from the backside. I don't think Lasekla saw him, but threw a touch ball over the linebackers, and nothing doing for Tevis. Good thing it wasn't a 2 yard further. That's cha-ching. There you go again. There's Boise State making points in every way possible. Kicking, running, passing, defense. I don't think they've scored in special teams tonight, but it's just what they do. That's why they're third in the nation right now. And they like to get up, get you down, and smother you.
Third in the nation in the polls, and the official BCS rankings standings will come out tomorrow night. Boise State's expected to be at the top of that list, and as we noted, more carnage today in the toward the top of those national polls. Ohio State trailing Wisconsin at halftime 21-3. Texas knocked off unbeaten Nebraska earlier today. So, you know, Boise State, and they're very good at it, focusing on who they're playing and their job at hand. But from the big picture, as the season goes along, the more of these power teams from AQ conferences that lose one or even two games, the better it is for Boise State.
Stay focused on the here and now. That's the Broncos.
Yell on the return again for San Jose State, just across the 20-yard line.
Turf Monster got him.
Yep. Visit waxsports.com. You will not only be able to keep up on the latest conference and tournament information, but also purchase the latest gear from your favorite team. Also, follow Wax Sports on Twitter and Facebook. So the San Jose State offense right back on the field quickly, not in exactly the manner they would have liked. Aaron Tevis putting up the pick six for Boise State. Broncos lead it 34-0. Just a gorgeous night here in San Jose. The weather's just absolutely fabulous for not only this, but we mentioned there are a lot of other activities going on sports-wise around the area. Lasekla's pass for Harrison is a little too tall, incomplete.
I don't think Harrison really wanted to go up, reach high for that ball, stretch his body out. You know, what we used to call alligator arms. You don't want to reach out too far, expose your ribs. Hurts a little bit. Kind of jumped up, kept his elbows in to protect himself. Wasn't able to come down with the ball.
You know, coaches always talk about that week-to-week philosophy. It makes a lot of sense for Boise State when you're at the top of the heap. But Tim Landis, the OC at San Jose State, also talked about it in terms of his head coach, Mike McIntyre, as the give is off to Rutley and very little room to run there. But even with all the injuries and five top 25 teams out of the first seven games, it's still week to week, do your job, even from the San Jose State perspective.
Now, we were in and around the program yesterday afternoon, and you can see that the players are upbeat. They have a positive attitude. Yep. They know that their future is in front of them. A lot of young guys getting reps, and real positive attitude from the coaching staff down through the team, trainers, everybody involved in the program. It's a program of the future.
Third and 12 for San Jose State in the here and now. Lasekla back to throw, steps out of the pocket, completes it to Rutley, has a little bit of running room, and has a first down.
Rutley's fun to watch. He's got some quick feet.
Elusive.
Yes, he is. When you look quick against Boise's defense, you are really quick. Watch number 9 out of your backfield
good,
right
good
here.
Good pocket presence, too, by Lasekla here.
Great job. That's good stuff.
George Iloka finally bringing him down. Quickly down to the field, and Jenny Kavanaugh.
Guys, it was interesting in talking to this coaching staff yesterday and the strength of schedule that they're playing, the 9th toughest schedule in the country. They said each and every week they saw a bit of improvement in the way the team prepared. Even defensive coordinator Kent Bear said some of these guys were taking pictures at Alabama a little wide-eyed. And then every week as they played a different ranked opponent, they kind of tightened things up a little bit. They even had some weaknesses in that Utah game. But he said every week the hope is that you see your players believing that they can be somebody someday. And if that's what it takes this year, that's what it's going to take for Mike McIntyre to build a program.
First 6 opponents that San Jose State has played from FBS, from the Bowl subdivision, went 64-16 last year. As we mentioned at the top, this is the 5th different top 25 team that they've had to play. Add all the injuries and inexperience, and it's tough. Fresno State comes to town next week. That's an in-state rival game and a conference game for San Jose State. Here they go on 2nd and 9. Lasekla throws it out here, incomplete.
You know, I thought what Coach McIntyre said was so appropriate. He said, you guys have to believe in yourself because really nobody else around the program really believes in you. And so it's a tight family. They've got to stay together and feel that they're going in the right direction, take care of things on and off the field, and believe. That's a big word, believe.
Tina Liana was the intended receiver on the last play, sixth play of the drive here on third and nine. Sekla. And a little bit of contact over there, and the San Jose State coaches wanted a flag, but don't get it. Intended receivers Kyle Nunn, the freshman out of Carson, California.
The corner made a collision, and I'm not sure if the ball was in the air or not. He was trying to jam the wide out. Quarterback came out with the ball pretty quick, and tough call. We know that Boise can score with 1:56 left. We saw it against Toledo last week. They took the ball on their own 8-yard line, and 40 seconds later,
Harrison Wade boots it. Chris Potter's back to receive it. Has it at the 21-yard line. Hit immediately. Dances away from a couple of tacklers and has some running room. Look out, 40. Has one man to beat, and that man slowed him up just enough. Nice return by Chris Potter, and he was hit almost as soon as he got the football. That's our boy 2K on the first hit down there. Potter shakes loose from that one, and then it's a little bit ahead of steam here and almost took it the distance.
How about Cedric Losey hustling downfield? Took the angle, proper pursuit angle, flagging back. Pylon back, I guess they say now, but kept that thing from going to the house. Cedric Losey, good job.
Chris Potter, the sophomore out of Westlake Village, California, just keeps finding more and more ways to contribute to what Boise State's doing. Right now he's doing it as a punt returner, doing a nice job. Kellen Moore fires complete to Tyler Shoemaker, and that'll be good for another first down. Kellen Moore having a very, very fine night. Kellen, let's look at some of what he's done so far this evening.
The word their coaches use so much is dialed in. Guy is dialed in. Understands what
back
they
to
want.
Live action, and Moore throws caught by Titus Young, but out of bounds. So it'll be only the second incompletion all night for Kellen Moore.
Wasn't out of bounds by much. Just again, Moore moving the pocket there a little bit. Got that one off about a click too late. Still threw the ball on the money. It was an inch out of bounds.
Kellen Moore's developed a very close friendship with Case Keenum, as the quarterback at Houston that's hurt and out for the season, and has had just mind-boggling numbers down there with the Houston Cougars. They text each other all the time, and Boise State coaches were telling us that, you know, they could probably flip-flop offenses and still be very good. They both understand the game so well. Here's Kellen Moore, a little screen. That's set up to Doug Martin. Has some running room, and look out here. 20, 15, 10. And pushed back inside the 5-yard line. Saw something flying down on the field there. I thought at first it was a flag, but it's not.
Watch your tailback, Doug Martin, number 22. Good job of looking off the linebackers by their quarterback, Kellen Moore. Martin kind of snakes his way downfield, but saving tackle.
Ronnie Yell.
Ronnie Yell playing to the echo of the whistle. Good job, Ronnie.
So it'll be first and goal from the 3-yard line with just over a minute to play. Second quarter, Boise State up 34 to nothing. Doug Martin is your setback.
It's heavy set. I think it's run, but nope, he runs the fade
pattern, and it is incomplete. Flag thrown in the corner of the end zone. Pass intended for Austin Pettis. It's 19, Peyton Thompson on the coverage there.
Pass interference, defense, number 19. By rule, the ball will be placed on the 2-yard line, first down.
Peyton trying to be physical there. Get his hand up and time the ball and get a strip at the same time. He just a little early. Good effort, though.
Very efficient, productive night.
For gain of one.
Kellen Moore, certainly on the penalty, you get 1 yard.
Yeah.
See if they play a little power football here and try and smash it in. It's Kellen Moore on the option. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Jeremy Avery.
Haven't seen the speed option yet from Kellen. Just a down the line pitcher keep by the quarterback. And I think I'd let the quarterback run it and take my chances.
There's so many different looks, multiple formations.
to such a multifaceted offensive attack. And to have that many different things in and execute them all so well is just amazing.
Brotsman, very well coached.
Extra point try just squeaks it through there. 41-0 in favor of Boise State. Take another look at this touchdown.
I've got a history with one of their offensive coaches, Brent Peasy, quarterback for us at Montana back in the 80s. And he's been a very successful coach for a long, long time. And he and Harson, Brent Peasy, Brian Harson, Chris Peterson himself is what they consider a genius offensive mind. He thinks the numbers he's put up, places he's been, Oregon, he's a quarterback at Cal Davis. He watches practice with the defense. So he's not totally involved in the offensive practice. But he does more film work with the offense. There's Killen. I know the next time you run speed option, Killen, they're going to want you to run it. So it's another little wrinkle from the playbook of Boise State. Prosser Washington, Killen's father, was his high school coach. Shattered every record you can imagine it.
Brandon Driver and David Freeman back to return the kickoff this time for San Jose State. Trevor Harmon puts a pretty good foot into it. It's a high kick, comes down to about the 10-yard line. This is Freeman across the 20, 25, sticks his head down to about the 28-yard line. We'd like to welcome our viewers from KTBS in Shreveport, Louisiana, KTVB in Boise, Idaho, KTFT in Twin Falls, Idaho, and SWX in Spokane, Washington. Thanks to all of you for tuning in.
Some Boise fans up there.
San Jose State back on offense now. First and 10 from their own 28. High snap, Sekla corrals it. There'll be a loss on that play.
Shotgun snap is not as easy as what you would think when you got to snap it. Maybe reach block, full gap.
Not sure we'll get another playoff. 13 seconds left in the second quarter. San Jose State, if they have the option, may just elect to go into halftime and try and regroup a little bit. They have been hit with a blitzkrieg here in the first half by Boise State, the number three team in the land. Broncos lead it 41-0 as we hit the halfway point. Brings us to the end of the first half with our score 41-0 Broncos. Stay tuned for the WAC Sports Network halftime show from San Jose. It's coming up next right here on the WAC Sports Network, a production of Learfield Sports. WAC Sports Network College Football is brought to you by Les Schwab Tire Centers, doing the right thing since 1952. RC Willie, your home, your way. Peterson Toyota in Boise, we'll do almost anything. Papa Murphy's, get a big pep for just $7. Now that's a pizza. CapEd, where membership supports education. And by Nampa Floor, go to getfloored.net for Bronco Nation savings. Back at halftime, Dave Harbison, Joe Glenn, Jenny Kavnar with Boise State out in front 41-0. Quickly down to the field, here is Jenny Kavnar with Chris Peterson.
Coach, the score sure says a lot right now, but how does it match up with your game plan coming in and the way these players have executed?
We played hard. We've been fairly clean. New half, and we'll see where we go from here.
You guys have had a lot of different guys be able to score tonight. What's it like to get your defense involved in the offense a little bit?
Yeah, when your defense scores, that always helps really change the momentum. And, you know, they're playing well. When you can get on the board defensively, that's always a good thing.
Kellen Moore now leads the all-time completions at Boise State. Can you ever just sit back in a game and really appreciate his craft?
Well, it's hard in a game, yeah. But usually after. I mean, Kellen's you know, he's a good player, a smart player, and he usually makes really good decisions.
All right, Coach, we'll talk to you after the game. Guys?
All right, thank you, Jenny, and thank you, Coach Chris Peterson. Chris Peterson has been very withdrawn in terms of any comments about the BCS or the big picture. He says, wait till December. It'll all kind of sort itself out. He continues to have his team focused, but everybody else is going to be talking about what transpires tomorrow when those BCS numbers come out.
Exactly. I approached him about, is this the best team he's had? And it's a little bit cautious. He said, we've only played five games. We've got a lot of season to go. And I said, through five games, is it the best team you've had? And he did a toe dance, but you could see the look in his eyes. He knows that this is something special. They are on a mission. They've got what I continue to call the eye of the tiger. This team is playing to get better every week, and I think they really are on to something special this year.
About 4.5 minutes to play now for Ohio State and Wisconsin, still 28-18. Wisconsin Badgers lead that one again. Nebraska, fifth-ranked team in the nation, knocked from the ranks of the unbeaten earlier today by Texas. There's Coach Mike McIntyre of San Jose State. We were very impressed with him, talking with him. It's going to be a long uphill battle, but he's got the wherewithal, I think, to make it happen. And Chris Peterson, we asked him about San Jose State, big picture, outside looking in. He said there's a lot of positives here, a lot of really good football players in this area, and doesn't take a whole lot, just a few things, a couple of players that you get here and there, you can turn it around fairly quickly if things break your way.
We had an expression when I was a kid, our mom would ask us how to eat an elephant. We had a big job to do, and we'd always say one bite at a time. And I think that's exactly where Mike McIntyre is at with his team. It's going to be a long and arduous process, but one bite at a time. They just keep getting better and keep believing. And
he, as we mentioned, he's a coach's son. His father, George, coached at Vanderbilt. And unfortunate story there, too. His father's been battling MS for a number of years, mostly bedridden now. When the floods hit Nashville this spring, they had to help him out of the house. And it's been a very unfortunate situation as the kick comes down, and it's a short one, and Boise State is able to jump on it for a minute there. It looked like San Jose State might come up with something, pulling something out of their hat on the opening kickoff of the second half. But Mike McIntyre still talks to his dad all the time, and you know, his dad, along with David Cutcliffe and Bill Parcells, really his role models.
A harrowing experience getting his father out of the floods in Nashville and made it all right and ended up saving some other people with a flotation mattress that his father was using.
Joe Southwick comes out, I believe, to start at quarterback here in the second half for Boise State. It is Southwick, and on the pitch, not a whole lot going for Boise State there.
Doug Martin gets about four, again, hard running. Good tackling there by the Spartans, rallying to the ball.
It's quite conceivable that Kellen Moore could be done for the night. Southwick, the Bay Area kid, gets the start here in the second half for Boise State.
Going to empty it out here, quads to the field. And motion back into a one-back set.
And I'll look at a little screen to Doug Martin. Complete. First down yardage across the 40 to about the 45-yard line. And the other interesting story about the Vanderbilt connection from Mike McIntyre, he was a ball boy on those teams when he was a kid. Vanderbilt played Alabama right to the gun, lost a close game. Bear Bryant came into the Vanderbilt locker room and talked to the Vanderbilt team when Mike McIntyre was just a kid. I mean, how big a thrill could that be for a legend, to witness a legend like that?
Bear was a legend, wasn't he?
Chris Potter lined up now out of the Wildcat for Boise State. He's got it on a little option play, keeps it across midfield.
Ran into one of his offensive linemen downfield, trying to hustle down and get him a block. Potter runs into Potter.
Chris Potter just keeps finding ways to get himself in, and the coaches talk about it. Every time we give him something, he does it so well that we have to find something else, some other way to incorporate him into what we're doing.
I wasn't joking. He ran into Nate Potter. No relation, but Nate was hustling downfield to get a block. Unbalanced trips to the field. I think it's something to his left.
Southwick on the handoff to Martin. Straight ahead. Not much doing there.
Tough tackle. Very tough tackle by Akeem King. That's
Anthony Larceval in there as well, 97.
That's who it was. It wasn't Akeem, it was Anthony Larceval. Good job, Anthony. still playing hard. Love to see that. Some pride in the program. No quit, these Spartans.
Second and 8 for Boise State with Southwick at quarterback. Pettis to the near side of the field. Southwick looking that way, and Pettis kept on going, and Southwick threw it short.
I think our wires were crossed there. They didn't read the coverage the same, and Pettis ran a go route. Southwick threw an out route.
There are a lot of folks that think Kellen Moore is a Heisman Trophy candidate as well. I think he's in the mix, certainly, and you could well get the invitation to New York as a finalist. But, I mean, he's so impressive. But if he doesn't play the entire second half, it's really tough to put up the kind of eye-popping numbers that might get you there. But much like the BCS conversation, it's all about team and about the short term, week to week, for Boise State and for Kellen Moore. Southwick throws, complete. Nice catch, Austin Pettis, down here at the 33.
I believe that's Austin's first catch of the game. Great one it was. Coach raves about Austin. If you get a chance to talk to him individually about number two as he slot receiver and gets a little boost to get himself out there. But they say this guy is a competitor, extraordinaire. Eighth play of the drive right here.
Opening drive of the second half, Boise State dominant in the first half, leading at 41-0. Joe Southwick has now taken over a quarterback for the Broncos.
Tight ends trade.
Southwick looking for Titus Young, incomplete.
I don't know why he came back over here. I don't know what his read was, but his line was sliding to the field. They unloaded on him, unblocked it. He had two guys covering the slant route to X on the single receiver side. I just need some reps. It's good that they're getting him in the game here, where he can throw the ball a little bit in the third quarter.
The Broncos starting center, Thomas Byrd, is also from the Bay Area. He and Southwick both did some media opportunities earlier this week with the Bay Area media. There's a pass caught by Titus Young at the 28. Put a knee down right there. Otherwise, he might well have busted that one loose.
Again, you see the athleticism of the wide receivers.
Well, and it's nice to be able to get your backup quarterback in there with the rest of the first team unit, so he gets to feel some of that cohesion just in case he ever needs to. Something, God forbid, from the Boise State perspective, something should ever happen to Kellen Moore.
He's got to get the keys to the car when things are on the line a little bit. Not that the game is on the line, but he's got a feel.
Yeah, last week, both Southwick and Michael Coughlin got in the game, but neither one of them threw a pass. Boise State threw two passes the entire second half. They really took the air out of the football after that, having that big lead against Toledo. Southwick stands in the pocket, delivers a nice strike to Austin Pettis, who shakes a tackler. 10, 5 out of bounds at the 3.
Ball had some zip on it right
did.
There. Now you know why they recruited him. Guy had it. Threw an out route to Pettis. That ball was on the express right
watch,
there.
Watch him stand in the pocket, nice and strong, straight up and zip it in there.
It's a tight spiral. Pettis knows what to do with the ball, doesn't he?
Eleventh play of the drive coming up now for Southwick and the Broncos. Doug Martin dots the I for Boise State, and he's got the football, trying to find a little bit of running room, and does. On second effort, he pounces into the end zone. Touchdown, Boise State.
There wasn't a lot there, Dave. He just hunted and peeked a little bit till he found a crease, and everybody stayed on their blocks. Pretty good effort by the Spartan defense.
Just side to side, hunting, trying to find a little room. And finally does, and Broncos are up 47-0.
Bene Ben Wickery put a good hit on him, but it just wasn't enough right at the 1 yard line to hold him out of the end zone.
That's Harmon in to try the extra point, and he converts it for Boise State to make it 48-0. Headed to break and coming right back, but let's take a look at the touchdown run by Doug Martin. As we head out, Broncos up 48-0. Welcome back to San Jose, California. Spartan Stadium, Dave Harbison, Joe Glenn, Jenny Kavnar with you. Boise State in command of this one, 48-0. This current San Jose State team coach going through some tough times, but a great football tradition. Bill Walsh here at San Jose State. Claude Gilbert, this is their ring of honor here at the stadium.
It's who's who. Dick Vermeil, Super Bowl winner, Hall of Famer. Louis Wright, one of the great Denver Broncos of all time.
Jeff Garcia's in that ring of honor.
Pop Warner, how about that?
That's a pretty good name. Yell on the return for San Jose State, out to about the 22-yard line. There's Pop Warner. Great athletic tradition here. They had a great track and field program here for years and years. 1968 Olympics.
Should we throw some names out?
Yeah, absolutely.
Al Order, one of the greatest discus throwers in the history of all track and field. They had a coach here named Al Fierbach, who was one of the greatest shot putters, world record holder in his day. Tommy Smith, John Carlos, gold medal winners.
Sekula completes it to Harrison. Harrison close to first down yardage out across the 30. I don't know that he participated in sports, but Peter Ueberroth, the former baseball commissioner and head of the USOC, has San Jose State ties. Jordan Lasekla, the 6'3", 205-pound senior from Newbury Park, California. Once he got his feet under him in this game, he's fared fairly well. He's had a little bit more time to throw, and they've gotten the ball out quicker. That's Rutley on the carry. Looks like maybe just a tad short of the first down, bring up third and about one.
Not a lot of running room in there, but they're fighting all the way. One of my all-name teams guys, Ina, at fullback now, doing some lead blocking for the Spartans.
He's their H-back, essentially. Mm-hmm. They get another opportunity to try and clear a hole for Rutley again here.
Need a first down.
Flags on the play as Lasekla goes on the keeper, has the first down for the time being.
Offense number 42 was not set. 5-yard penalty, third down.
There's your guy, Leah Ina, guilty of the penalty. That'll back him up five and bring up third and six. He was not set.
It's not moving forward. It shouldn't be a penalty. He's got to be set for a second if it wasn't. If it was a shift. Did not see the play from inception.
Rutley back in as the running back for San Jose State. Trips right. One wide receiver left for Jordan Lasekla. Back to throw. Gets it out of there, and it is incomplete. Pretty good coverage over there.
Too good.
And now here comes the flag. The intended receiver is Kyle Nunn. Jarrell Gibbons on the coverage for Boise State, which brings us to
defensive pass interference, number four. Ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. First down.
Jarrell got there a little too quick.
Yeah, out of Miami, Florida, and El Camino Junior College. Something we should have mentioned earlier, Coach, and we did not. Jamar Taylor is not with the Boise State Bronco football team. Did not make the trip. He's been suspended for disciplinary reasons, a violation of a team rule. So Jarrell Gibbons getting the start at cornerback.
Represent quite well. That's a great play there. He just a little too quick.
Give the Spartans a first down via penalty. And here is Rutley finding a little bit of running room.
8-9.
Yep.
Well blocked up front. Good effort by the offensive line. Ailao Iliapo, I had to try it. The point of attack. Had some good play from David Quisenberry tonight. Left tackle. 72 Isaac Liatiota.
Very good, Coach.
Good Polynesian guys in there. Tough dudes.
I'll try Shea McClellan.
Irish
making
guy.
The tackle.
Slant.
Lasekla on the slant. Ready. Intended for Beachman and incomplete.
I like the call. That's a pass that you can get off and get it off now to a nice looking receiver on it. Just, I don't think he was ready for it.
Now, Mike McIntyre, first-year head coach, first coaching opportunity. We mentioned a couple of times he's worked under Bill Parcells, and after this play, we'll tell you a little bit more about that story because it's a good one. Third and one for the Spartans. Rutley dives forward but is not going to pick up the first down. Nice job, Winston Venable and George Iloka, those safeties we featured a little bit earlier, stop them short of the first down.
It was run blitz all the way. They had the linebackers mugged up, meaning the linebackers were right on the line of scrimmage. And on the snap, they brought the house straight ahead. They did not want to give up a first down. They want no momentum going to the blue.
Harrison Wade in to punt it once again. Potter deep to receive.
Shield.
Busy night for Harrison Wade.
Shield punt formation.
There's a booming kick. Potter will field it at the 20. Has a little bit of a seam and across the 30, 35, 40. Chris Potter still on his feet out across the 45-yard line to about the 47. Excellent field position once again for Boise State when we come back from a break. Stay with us. 48 to nothing. You're watching the WAC Sports Network, a production of Learfield Sports. Out in front, 48 to nothing. 48 nothing here. Some other scores of note from around the country. Taking a look around the country today, our out-of-town scoreboard sponsored by Fisher's Document Systems. Do you love your copier company? How about those upsets today, Coach?
I love it. Wisconsin beating Ohio State.
Here is Coughlin on the first down quarterback keeper.
Oh,
the ball is loose, and San Jose
strip.
State jumps on it at the 45-yard line.
Great strip. Great strip. I think number 53 got the strip. Vincent Abbott, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see who got the strip here. Oh, yeah. Hustling Vincent. Great job by Vincent Abbott.
Out of Long Beach, California. Nice play there. Very, very nicely done.
That's a hustle play right there. Team that's down 48 to nothing. You got a guy running out, running the quarterback down on the perimeter, reach out and strip the ball. Great hustle. What score?
So with the BCS standings due out tomorrow night, top-ranked Ohio State goes down at the hands of Brett Bielema and Wisconsin in Madison. Texas knocks off unbeaten Nebraska. South Carolina coming off the upset of Alabama as the tables turned on them by Kentucky. So yeah, that's why they play the games. And here's LaSecla stepping up into the pocket, throws incomplete.
That ball was a strike on the money. Throw Jordan. Tried right. to run before he caught
let's,
the ball.
Let's finally work in our story about Bill Parcells and Mike McIntyre and that connection. McIntyre was an assistant coach at Ole Miss, and he was on the road recruiting somewhere in rural Alabama, checked his phone and had a message on the phone from Bill Parcells. He thought, Mike McIntyre thought, yeah, this might be a prank, and he called a couple of his buddies and said, you guys pulling something on me? And said, no, no, no. So he called his wife, and his wife said, Bill Parcells wants to talk to you. Finish it up after this play. LaSecla on the give to Freeman. Nothing doing there. Chase Baker, check it. It's 47 rather than 37 on the hit for Boise State. But then he called David Cutcliffe, the head coach at Ole Miss, who was working for at the time. And David Cutcliffe says, Bill Parcells wants to talk to you. And sure enough, he did want to talk to him. Bill Parcells was considering actually taking the job at Kentucky at the time and had called around some SEC coaches, and the name of Mike McIntyre kept coming up, and he said, Bill Parcells finally figured out it was George McIntyre's kid, and he had coached with George McIntyre at one point. Mike went into Dallas and met with Bill Parcells, didn't think he was going to get the job, but he stood up in the interview and said, Coach Parcells, who do I have to talk to convince that I'm the one you should hire for this job? Put him in with Jerry Jones, a couple of other coaches, and ultimately they hired Mike McIntyre. Sekla under pressure escapes it for a moment, but finally the swarming Boise State
Fury
defense corrals him at about the 44-yard line. And McIntyre went on to tell us last night, first 2 years under Bill Parcells were really tough. Parcells was really hard on him.
A harrowing experience.
But then the next 2 years, Parcells apparently started to trust him, and he had a really great experience and learned a lot from Bill Parcells.
Well, there's no question that he talked a lot about evaluating personnel, learning how to evaluate.
Learned how to organize practice. Lasekla's a little banged up now, the quarterback for San Jose State. He's taken a lot of abuse.
That was some violence there.
Right there, he was under heavy pressure from that Boise State pass rush. Short punt this time, and it'll be bouncing out of bounds. Whereas actually rolling dead rather than bouncing out of bounds at the 30-yard line. And we are once again headed to break. It's Spartan Stadium in San Jose. Boise State Broncos up on the Spartans 48-0. Stay with us. Back at Spartan Stadium in San Jose, Boise State well on their way to extending the nation's longest winning streak to 20 in a row. They just announced the Ohio State-Wisconsin score here, much to the delight of the Boise State fans. Be sure to catch next week's WAC Sports Network Game of the Week as the Fresno State Bulldogs take on San Jose State. Our coverage begins at 5 p.m. Pacific time right here on the WAC Sports Network. Joe Southwick is back in the game, rather, quarterback for Boise State.
As we've said, this is a good-looking guy. 6'1", 195-pound freshman from Danville, California.
Jeremy Avery in the backfield beside him.
Screen, he won a screen and it didn't materialize.
Takes off and runs, and he's got some wheels. Across the 40, 45, and rocked down to midfield, ball loose again, and San Jose State is on it once again.
Our backup quarterbacks keep fumbling the ball where Killen might come back in.
Let's take a look at what happened here. He had a nice game, terrific play.
Who stripped him this time?
The same guy.
How about Abbott?
Vincent Abbott, hustling from behind.
Vincent Abbott. Hey, Vincent's gonna get some
Rhino
kind of a
Gonzalez
sticker for his helmet.
Rhino Gonzalez.
Something. That's great hustle.
The fumble.
Vincent Abbott, Long Beach, California.
Well,
great hustle.
Chris Peterson has to have something to look
at. Oh,
I
know. He's not going to be happy.
There's your turnover story. Boise State with two and San Jose State with one.
Want to tie it together.
And Faulkner in at quarterback now for the San Jose State Spartans. We mentioned Lasekla was a little banged up during that last series. Faulkner delivers a strike out here. It's complete to Noah Grigsby. That's a gain out to the 44-yard line of Boise State for the Spartans.
5'10", 170-pound freshman. Got some scoop. Los Angeles, California. Got a little speed out here on the coast, Dave. It's a nice throw. First throw from Freeman.
Faulkner is out of Highland Village, Texas, 6'2", 205, and a junior. He's done some nice things when he's had the opportunity for San Jose State. Here is Rutley on the carry, not much doing there. Once again, it's Jarrell Gibbons on the hit. Let's head down to the field and check in with our sideline correspondent, Jenny Kavanaugh. Second and 11. We'll get back with Jenny in just a minute. Faulkner remains a quarterback for the Spartans on the second down play. And back to throw. Faulkner stands in there nice. Good mechanics. Ball knocked loose. Incomplete. Right, back down to the field. Here is the aforementioned Jenny Kavanaugh. Jenny.
Yeah, guys, Vincent Abbott with those two forced fumbles. No one more proud of him down here than his defensive line coach, Bryant Young. The guy had a 14-year career in the NFL, mostly played here in the Bay Area with the 49ers. And, you know, he really wanted to get into coaching, so he went back to his alma mater of Notre Dame, was a grad assistant last year. And then as soon as Mike McIntyre got the job here, he found a way to get introduced to him, had a conversation, and said, this is what I want to do. I want to be back in the South Bay of San Francisco. But he's not the most famous 49er that's returned to this school. Of course, as we all know, that would belong to Bill Walsh. He still remains on the Hall of Fame ring, as you guys mentioned earlier.
Brian Young was about as good as it got in the NFL in terms of defensive lineman for a 14-year career. That stretch, he was coming out of Notre Dame. He was really a key cog in those great 49er teams.
49ers went on a tear. Now they got to get it picked back up. I think they're 0-4 so far this year. See today's paper, Joe Namath bragging up Alex Smith. Give the guy a chance. Let's get behind Alex. And I believe he's right. I coached against Alex when he was at Utah. The guy's got it. Just think the team's got to rally around him a little bit. Got to get some help from the whole team.
San Jose State calls a timeout. They seem to have a little bit of difficulty getting the play call in, getting their signals squared away.
Faulkner's getting some playing time. I don't. Second came off on his own power, but looks shaken up a little bit, and I doubt if he'll return. He is up and around.
Both of our starting quarterbacks may be done for the night. It's been a very, very nice night for Kellen Moore and the Boise State offense, and they are just a juggernaut when you start looking at the total offense leaders in yards per game. They are right there, number five. Oregon's a powerhouse offensively. We've seen Nevada, Kaepernick, and that crew can really get it done. Bernard Robinson in Michigan is an electrifying player.
Fifth play in this drive.
It's a fourth down play, fourth and 11. They're going to go for it here with Faulkner under pressure, and down he goes. Kyrie Marshall, number 41 in there, out of Phoenix, Arizona, the freshman. Well, we talked with Pete Kwiatkowski, the defensive coordinator and D-line coach, yesterday. Watch his guys go to work here. But I talked to Coach K, and I said, you know, as I look at this, you're losing Ryan Winterswijk. He's a senior. Looks like all the rest of these guys are packed, and he just kind of sat there with that cat that swallowed the canary grin and said, uh-huh. He's got Billy Wynn coming back, Chase Baker, Shea McClellan, Marshall, Root, Crawford, all really talented young players getting a chance to play in the rotation. Future's very bright for that defense. Here's Jeremy Avery on the carry for the Broncos. A couple of yards on the play. There's Pete Kwiatkowski. He's an intense character, isn't he?
Oh, I love Pete. Coached against him when he was at Montana State years ago. I was at Montana, and he had his eyebrows down then. He's a young coach. Good one.
Is that a good thing, eyebrows down?
Oh, he's focused. Tough guy, too. He was a great player at Boise State. He's a defensive lineman for Bill Dutton. He credits Bill with a lot of what he's learned in coaching. Former Boise State assistant coach, Bill Dutton.
Second and nine. Coughlin back in at quarterback. Gives it off to our guy, Kaiserman. Matt Kaiserman running around left side and has close to first down yardage.
It'll be a little short. Third and, well, I take it back. He's got a pretty good spot. Looks like they got the first.
Out of Nampa, Idaho, Matt Kaiserman. He was fun to watch last week. Broncos got the ball at some point late third, early fourth quarter, and the entire drive was Matt Kaiserman. Play after play after play. I think it was 7-8 carries in a row, and he finally punched it in for a touchdown. They really like him, too. They want to find more ways to get him involved in the base offense, too.
Love his toughness. You got a bunch of clean jerseys in here right now that are getting some young Boise Broncos involved.
Broncos well in control. Kaiserman on the carry again. This will be good for a first down. 48-0, 2:20 to play here in the third quarter.
Tackled by Joe Negros. Gonna give it up easy. These guys are in here fighting. Chance to get better.
Geraldo Hewatts in at a wide receiver, 82 there for Boise State.
Good looking guy.
He comes wide to the near side of the field. Tight ends. Flipping. And Coughlin will pitch it to Kaiserman running right. Behind all that activity on the right side, he has a very nice run. At the end of it, he might have lost the ball momentarily, but I think he got it back himself. Moved the chains again for Boise State.
B'nai Ben-Wickery, not afraid. He came up, put a good lick on him. Sure tackle from the safety position. Young guys.
As we get into this stage of the game, you see some faces and some uniforms you might not have seen. We talked with Coach Chris Peterson a little bit yesterday, too, about walk-ons and the impact that they have had on the Boise State program. You may see some of those fellows in here in the late third and early fourth quarter. Coughlin hands it off to Kaiserman again, hit behind the line of scrimmage, falls forward. Not much doing there. And
Tyrone Croft.
Call it no gain.
Coming off the edge.
The most notable current former walk-on for Boise State's Ryan Winterswijk. Let's take a look at this run by Kaiserman and the defensive hit as well. 2K2 Iapatoa. Not sure I got that one right, Coach.
It's a challenge.
Can we just call him 2K?
That's good.
Tui Peloto.
Everybody will know 2K.
Look back at my hyphenetic spelling. A little easier when you do it that way. Here's Kaiserman on the third and 12 carry. Again, loss on the play, knocked down. Pick up that story about the walk-ons as we get going in the fourth quarter. Probably the final play of the third there as the Broncos now look at, check that was a second down play there. Scoreboard was wrong. It's now third and 14. But the final seconds of the third quarter ticking down. We head to the break leading up to quarter number four. Boise State in control, leading at 48-0. You are watching the WAC Sports Network, a production of Learfield Sports. Boise State Broncos jumped on San Jose State early, hit them hard, and on cruise control now, leading at 48-0. Broncos facing a third and 14 play in San Jose State territory.
Senior quarterback Mike Coughlin at the helm.
Throwing it out here, and a little bump by the defensive back. I think they will call out. There comes the laundry.
I agree with that.
At first, I thought they were going to just kind of let that one go or maybe say an uncatchable ball, but nope, the flag comes in, and that'll be a walk-off against San Jose State University.
Here's a wheel route, Davin. As the receiver started to turn to wheel it up.
There was no foul for pass interference. The ball was ruled uncatchable.
Okay, oh, right the first time.
Fair enough.
All right, quick note of business. This copyrighted telecast is the property of Learfield Sports, under rights granted by the Western Athletic Conference. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, reproduction, or other dissemination or use of this telecast, or any part of it without the express written consent of Learfield Sports is prohibited.
Prohibited.
That means don't do it.
Okay.
Fourth and 14. Looks like the Broncos will line up to go for it here rather than trying the long field goal.
It's a JV game in essence. Backups are all in for Boise.
Coughlin to throw. Fires it complete on the far side. I believe that's Potter on the receiving end. It is. It'll be short of the first down, though. He's pushed out of bounds at the 18. So the ball goes over on downs to San Jose State.
Freshman B'nai Ben-Wickery in. Make the play. Good job. Where the chains were.
Take a look at some numbers through the first three quarters of action. Boise State really doing a nice job. Averaging 47.5 points per game here in 2010 and 521 yards per game. Pretty good pace here. 174 rushing, 292 passing. If my math is any good, that adds up to about 474.
It's getting a lot of clean jerseys on the field for Boise State.
Freeman on the carry for San Jose State. Pushed back after a very, very short game. Another Mike McIntyre kind of note, factoid. He played a couple years under his dad at Vanderbilt, then transferred and played his final 2 years at Georgia Tech. And then coming out of college, he spent a year or two managing a restaurant. And his younger brother and those around him just constantly shaking their head at that team. Man, why isn't this guy coaching?
Yeah.
Eventually, he got back into the coaching game, was a GA at Georgia Tech, and moved on to some other situations. And again, as we've talked about, worked under David Cutcliffe and Bill Parcells.
I believe it's in his blood.
Faulkner back to throw, has a man open, and it is incomplete, intended for Beachman.
Nice throw, catchable ball. Did reach out, it stretched him out. Just couldn't quite handle it.
So it's Chandler Jones it rather in. Than Beachman 89
it was,
instead
yeah.
of 88.
Chandler just a freshman.
Faulkner's a big kid, 6'2", 205. Seems to have some tools.
Good looking guy.
Quarterback of the future, you would imagine here. They had a three-way quarterback battle back in spring ball and early in training camp. That pass is complete. Beachman on the receiving end, but that'll be short of the first down.
Punting situation. Here comes the punt team.
Harrison Wade has had a nice game punting the football.
Averaging over 40 yards a punt. Halftime, Wade was averaging 41.8 on four punts. Good hang time, which is so important.
Josh Borgman's back to receive this one for Boise State. He is one of the walk-on players that have had an impact for the Broncos. Wade's kick, low, but very, very good distance. And Borgman backpedals to the 21, drops it momentarily, picks it up, and then has a full head of steam. Well, like a bat out of heck, up to about the 38-yard line. There is a flag on the play, though, on this punt return. So let's see what that is about.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Receiving team number four. Half the distance from the spot of the foul. First down, media timeout.
Headed to break, Boise State in command, 48 to nothing. Back in San Jose, Dave Harbison, Joe Glenn, Jenny Kavnar, and the Boise State Broncos well in command, 48 to nothing here in the fourth quarter. Many of these same Wax Sports Network stations carrying the second game of our doubleheader once we're done here, and it's a good one. Nevada climbing the national polls on the road on the islands to take on Hawaii. Southwick on the handoff to Avery, and we'll find some running room along over there on the right side.
Jarvis Hodge. There you go.
Pardon? Phoenix, Arizona.
Avery. Might have been sent to the showers.
Ramon Muldrow back out on the field for San Jose State. He's on crutches here. Wishing for the best for him.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Good player. Great story about how he's getting a college education and having a college football career. You hate to see injuries. San Jose State has just seen way too many of those.
14 children in the family. And
pass incomplete.
Good luck, Ramon Muldrow.
Mentioned a couple times, Bears repeating with the BCS standings due to come out officially tomorrow night. Some upsets around the top 25 and in the top 10, let's call it. And from Boise State's perspective, first one loss or two loss, the more of these AQ teams that go down to defeat, the better from Boise State's perspective. Ohio State falls to Wisconsin. Texas knocks off Nebraska. Texas not in the top 25, first time in a long time. South Carolina upended by Kentucky. Third and three for the Broncos, and Southwick to throw. Over the middle, it is complete. It's Hewat on the reception. I'll check it, it's Burks. No, it is Hewat, beg your pardon, 82. First down for Boise State. And, you know, the Boise State is all likelihood going to be at the top of the BCS standings when they come out for the first time tomorrow night. Whether they can maintain that with all the computer formulas and everything else through the course of the season, yet to be determined.
The book is they'll start chipping away at him because of the strength of schedule. Remains to be seen. just keep beating tar out of people that are on their schedule.
And there's Hewat again, and off the reception as
nice
a little
tackle.
Bit of a head of steam. Picks up a good 6, maybe 7 yards out close to the 35-yard line. Quickly, let's go down on the field. Here's Jenny Kavnar.
You guys talking about the BCS. We know that Coach Peterson doesn't like to talk publicly about the BCS that much until December, but they said they can't really control if their players are talking about it amongst themselves in the locker room. They also said when we were talking to Pete Kwiatkowski yesterday, the defensive coordinator, he said when the so-called experts don't give our kids credit, that fires them up. And you know what? These coaches don't mind a little extra motivation throughout the season.
Southwick on the pitch to Hodge. Across the 35.
Nice tackle.
Upended. Nice job there.
I've got it. Anthony Pohahu. Close. Good tackle, Anthony.
If you say so, Coach.
Regardless, it's a nice tackle by number 51, Anthony.
There it is. And, you know, a lot of the people that are critics of the BCS, and I guess I would fall into that category, the biggest concern or the biggest criticism is the automatic qualifier status. Boise State's likely to be number one, but the ACC has one team in the current top 25, Florida State, at number 16. The Big East has one, West Virginia barely in the top 25 at number 25. More after this play, and Southwick throwing to Potter, incomplete, flag on the play. But the WAC has two teams in the top 25, Boise State at 3, Nevada at 19, Mountain West has 3, and yet neither one of those conferences has.
Offense number 28.
Somebody's voting for him.
Result of the play is fourth down.
Penalty was a chop block against Boise State. It's declined to bring up fourth down. But so those two conferences do not have the automatic qualifier, and yet the Big East and the ACC continue to have automatic qualifier status. And that's one of the criticisms.
You know what they're going to say. They always come back to strength of schedule.
But the point is that the ACC and the Big East don't offer that much strength of schedule anymore. I'll buy the argument
proven.
When you start talking about the SEC or the Big 12 or the Big 10.
That's proven.
That's yelled back to receive the punt. Goes out of bounds at about the 27-yard line. And we'll head to break and pick up the discussion on the pros and cons of the BCS. When we come back in a moment, 10:27 to play in the fourth quarter. Broncos lead the Spartans 48-0. Back in San Jose, let's check out our hit of the game brought to you by Nampa Floors and Interiors. Go to getfloor.net for Bronco Nation savings. Doubling up on this one, Coach, how about Travis Johnson?
I love this guy right here from San Jose. He, tough customer, sure tackler, and double hit of the game. Travis Johnson from San Jose, California. Hats off to Travis.
Fumble in the backfield for San Jose State. They do recover it themselves, and we've got a quarterback change for the Broncos now. Dasmond Stewart is in the game. We mentioned they had a three-way quarterback battle in training camp. Eventually, LaSecla came out of it. Stewart not able to handle the first snap for him. Freeman, though, in the backfield able to recover and limited the loss to a couple of yards.
Another freshman, Dasmond Stewart from Oxnard, California. He's having trouble with the snap.
He is. A little case of nerves, perhaps, for Stewart.
So
back to about the line of scrimmage. Picking up on the BCS conversation. Went back and looked at the last 3 years. If you were to eliminate the automatic qualifier, just take the top 10 teams. The 10 teams based on the formula. Keep the formula. Last year, the WAC of the Mountain West would have been represented along with the 6 automatic qualifier schools. The 2 previous years, 1 year, the WAC would have been represented, and the Mountain West would have been the conference that was not represented. And one other year, the WAC and the Mountain West would have been in. The ACC and the Big East would not have had a team in that top 10 qualifying if you were just going to go based on the formula, take those top 10 teams. Pass by Stewart is complete this time. Come up well short of the first down.
You can say all you want about automatic qualifiers. I've seen enough of this football team in the orange and blue right now to tell you straight up, they've got a football team. They're well coached. They flat can get after it on Offense, defense, and special teams. One of the better teams in the United States, bar none.
No question about it. I mean, and Ohio State is obviously going to fall in the AP and coaches' polls. Broncos will get it back here, and this is Borgman, Josh Borgman.
Borth made the tackle. Right, doing special teams, too. Learned offense, playing on defense.
Borgman's one of those guys, too, that's a walk-on, and we'll pick up on that story in a moment. Right now, back down to the field, and Jenny Kavnar.
Yeah, as you mentioned earlier in the broadcast, Dave, this week Boise State made it official that Kellen Moore's brother Kirby will redshirt this year. Now, as a wide receiver, he did log his very first touchdown from his brother last season as a true freshman against San Jose State. It was a 61-yarder. Nevertheless, it was the first brother-to-brother scoring pass in school history. They sure hope it's not the last between the Moores. Of course, they will have next season. They hope to connect again as Kellen will be a senior and Kirby will be a redshirt sophomore. The coaches just felt that the redshirt would give Kirby the opportunity to get bigger, faster, stronger, and not have to do it and worry about doing that while playing. And as you mentioned, the depth chart is great at wide receiver, so what a chance for Kirby to just improve on his game.
Thanks, Jenny. Kaiserman on the carry for the Broncos. Gets about five, bring up second and five.
Hard fought five. Warded off a couple tacklers and bouncing it outside. Tough running. Matt Kaiserman, Idaho boy, representing. Gabe Linehan, Chandler Cook, Trayton.
Coughlin on the give to Kaiserman, and he is dragged down from behind. There's your guy Abbott again.
I love this guy. He's playing with a lot of heart. He doesn't look at no scoreboard. Guy pursues. Got some foot speed. Watch him run.
Just chase that one down from the backside.
Sophomore out of Long Beach, 6'2", 230. Got some scoop. Have a little fun playing this game.
Out of the shotgun, it's Coughlin on third and 11. Pressure coming, and he throws it incomplete.
Good pressure.
Intended for Linehan down the right side. And the punt team will come on for the Broncos.
Abbott again applying the pressure on Coughlin. As well as Foloi. Bye.
Now Myers working on Abbott, and Abbott comes in.
Got a shot from his buddy Foloi.
Trevor Harmon, the punter once again for Boise State. Bounces at the 32 and out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. Broncos led it 41-0 at halftime. They've added a touch here in the second half. In control, 48-0, Boise State over San Jose State. Kellen Moore and the Boise State Broncos comfortably in control, 48-0. Our delivery of the game presented by Chicago Connection, the official pizza of the Boise State Broncos, and it was one for the record books.
We saw history as Kellen Moore delivers an out route to Titus Young, become the all-time completion quarterback in the history of Boise State football, and there are some great quarterbacks.
Past Bart Hendricks on that list, just two behind Ryan Dinwiddie now on the all-time touchdown list for Boise State.
Zabransky, how far back you want to go? These guys, they had quarterbacks in spades since the 60s, 70s.
Continue with Desmond Stewart, number 18 at quarterback for the Spartans. Almost didn't want to give that football up.
Oh, no, the tailback.
The read option.
Tailback wouldn't let go. We're fighting over it. There you go.
There's Kellen Moore. He has taken the entire second half off 14 of 16, 231. We mentioned, you know, he's in the Heisman conversation. I don't know that by playing one half each week, he's going to have much chance to put up the kind of eye-popping numbers that are going to get him that hardware. Heck of a football player, no question.
Beautiful quarterback. Talked a little bit about the success that some of the coaches have had.
Pressure this time.
Boise State, and I didn't know if.
Coming on Stewart. Down he goes.
Graphic on that. Get a chance maybe before the end of the game to look at some of the success that Boise State have had with coaches dating back to the 60s. Lyle Smith, the field's named after him in Boise. Lyle started the program from a junior college back in Idaho, and very, very successful. Then they became a four-year school. And Tony Knapp, amongst others, Jim Kreiner, very successful coach there.
Houston Nutt was here for a year, and Dirk Cutter had a lot of success, and Dan good, Hawkins. And
good friend Pokey Allen.
Yep, Pokey Allen was one of the first ones to really put Boise State football on the map, generate some excitement for it. Josh Borgman on the punt return for the Broncos out across the 40, 42-yard line. Mentioned earlier, Borgman is one of those walk-ons that Chris Peterson was talking about yesterday. Currently, Ryan Winterswijk's the one that stands out. Jake Hess, Drew Wright, Josh Borgman, Kyle Brotzman is another guy that's had some success here. Down to the field we go, and Jenny Kavnar.
Well, one more of those guys with some success has been Billy Wynn. He's kind of the energy on that defense. We talked to Pete Kwiatkowski yesterday. He said he's a really big, big kid. He can be goofy one minute and pretty serious the next. You know, it's kind of all about timing for him. I think nothing describes his timing better, though, than the cover of Sports Illustrated just a couple weeks ago. He's the only one with his face visible out of all of him and his teammates on the cover. He said he had no idea that picture was being taken. His helmet was just fogging up, so he took it off to clean it off. And of course, he's now the face of Boise State, if you will. And as we've mentioned in a couple other broadcasts within the last couple weeks, Dave, we just hope that cover is not a curse.
That's Billy's story, and he's sticking with it.
That is a nice do he's got going.
I love it.
Isn't it.
I love it. They say he's a lot of fun. Las Vegas, Nevada.
Yep.
Great personality.
Coach K said he's one guy that he can tweak and push the buttons on a little bit, but he's an exuberant fella, no question about it.
Has a little fun at life, a little fun at football. Serious when he has to be, and that guy can play. Lay it on the line for the Broncos, I guarantee.
Nice run by Kaiserman, and Chris Peterson talked about some of the walk-ons from the past that have had success here. Vinny Peretta was one that came up, Randy Trotman, Brock Forsey, and Jeff Putzier, a couple of others that were originally walk-ons at Boise State.
Great players, Trotman, what a dude. Great football player, tough. High formation for the Boise Broncos. Look like we're gonna flat run the game out here. Getting downhill, the offensive line coming off. The young guys getting a chance to punch it in there, and wide base, short choppy steps, move that line of scrimmage. Fundamental, they're gonna run the base offense here. Don't think we'll have any long counts either. They're going to just learn how to come off the ball and tag them, and they're going to be building some pride on the Spartan defense too. This kids are playing hard.
Charles Leno Jr. in at left tackle for the Broncos, among the second teamers in there. There's a completion to Hewat. Brian Harsin, the offensive coordinator for the Broncos. He does a great job, and Chris Peterson obviously gets a lot of the credit, and justifiably so, for the offensive design. Brian's a pretty sharp character. Wouldn't be surprised if there's a head coaching gig in his future at some point.
Oh, I think there's head coaches all over that staff. And it just takes time, the right situation. I don't know who'd want to leave Boise right now with the way things are going.
Heiserman on the carry once again for the Broncos. Pushed out of bounds about the 26-yard line. On the other side of the field, Mike McIntyre's in his first year. He is a 172-page binder. That's his blueprint, his plan for success here at San Jose State. So he's well organized.
He's thought about it.
Learned that,
no doubt.
Parcells has a plan. It's not going to happen overnight. He knows that. Says he has the support of the administration. I'm not sure he had a had a page in that 172-page binder for how to deal with a juggernaut like Boise State.
They didn't make that page. Juggernaut is right. Uh-oh, we got a little extracurricular going. Break. Beck Judge says break. Split them up.
Spartans get Fresno State coming in. In-state rival, that's next week. Broncos play again a week from Tuesday at home against Louisiana Tech.
Seventh play into the drive for the backups for the Boise Broncos. I formation, offset fullback, we're gonna run the toss.
Kaiserman on the toss, puts his head down across the 25, about the 22-yard line on third and four, may move the chains.
They did move the chains. How about that?
With less than 2 minutes to go, that probably will be pretty much the icing on the cake for this one as far as clock running out is concerned. In fact, the next two games for Boise State are both at home. They get Louisiana Tech at home, then Hawaii at home.
Four of their last six. So the schedule certainly in their favor down the stretch.
And obviously it's a ways down the road, but they've been circling that game for Boise State at Nevada, the 26th of November.
Don't count the rainbows out.
Yeah, Nevada, both teams have to take care of some business between now and then. Looking forward to seeing the game coming up next year on the WAC Sports Network, many of these same stations, Nevada at Hawaii, end of November. Boise and Nevada in a showdown.
There's a couple showdowns on the horizon, but one at a time.
Yeah, and on the national scene, we mentioned Ohio State lost, and South Carolina lost, and Nebraska lost, but the next group that's coming out of there includes Auburn, who was very impressive, still unbeaten, and Michigan State, 7-0.
7-0.
For the first time since 1966. Kaiserman with the football again for the Broncos.
Dave threw me a wrinkle here a little bit ago. Name somebody off that team.
66 Michigan State team. You came up with, I only knew one. You came up with more than one.
I think the kicker was Bubba Pisa. But Bubba Smith, who doesn't know Bubba from the Golden Triangle down in Texas?
Miller Lite commercials years and years ago, right?
Wasn't he a beauty?
He was a heck of a football player.
What a man.
Coach's favorite play, the kneel down.
There
at the
it
end
is.
Of the game.
Genuflect.
And Boise State Broncos, 48-0 is your final. It clearly could have been even much more of a margin than that. San Jose State, really scrappy. Chris Peterson coming out to shake hands with Mike
very
McIntyre.
Gracious. Very sportsmanlike, very
Muldrow
gracious.
On crutches out on the field now to shake hands with one or more of the Boise State players. And we again, hope everything for the best for him and for San Jose State going forward. More after this, including back down to the field for some post-game comments from Chris Peterson. 48-0 the final. You're watching the WAC Sports Network, a production of Learfield Sports.